Hello students, yes. Today we are going to complete all the remaining concepts what that present in the lesson force and pressure. In the last class we are going to discuss about the pressure exerted by the liquid. How exactly the pressure exerted by the liquid and how the pressure gives some of the forces to the wall of the container. That all the concepts we study in the last class. Now today we are going to discuss about pressure exerted by the gases. Is that pressure exerted by the gases? Is it? Is the pressure exerted by the gases? Yes, of course. Of course, the pressure exerted by the gases. To explain this one, okay, to explain the concept of pressure exerted by the gases, now we will take one example. Okay, now we will first discuss with the example. What is that example to explain the pressure exerted by the gases? Take one balloon, okay. Take one single balloon. Now blow air to that balloon. After blowing the air to the balloon, after filling that air to the balloon, what happens to the balloon size? Is that size of the balloon is increases or decreases? Tell, is that the size of the balloon is increases or decreases? Definitely the size of the balloon gets increases. Why it increases? What makes that size of the balloon get increases? Is that any force exerted on that? Is that the sum of the pressure is exerted on the balloon? Yes. When you are going to blow the balloon in, blow the air inside the balloon, what happens? The pressure is increases in that balloon. Due to the increase in the pressure, what happens? The size of the balloon get increases. Now understood the example? Is the gases what we are going to blow in that balloon also exert some of the pressure. Understood the example? Now see this. The air pressure arises. When that air pressure arises, when some of the gas is going to arises, the pressure means due to the contact collision of the tiny molecules of gas present in the air with the wall of the container. When that we are going to tell that the pressure is arises in that balloon means, okay, when you are going to blow the air to the balloon, what happens? The sum of the tiny particles that present in the gases are collide each other. Collision takes place. What is the meaning of collision? What is this colliding takes place? What is this collision means? If any two particles are react each other, collide each other. Consider that this is the particle A, this is the particle B. If these two particles are react each other, are collide each other, then the we say that the particles are in the collision. What is collision? When any of the two particles are collide each other, that process we call it as an collision. What is collision? If any of the two particles are collide each other, then that process we call it as an collision. Understood collision? Then when we said that the air pressure is arises, we can say that air pressure arises due to the contact collision. That means it should be in the collided contact collision of tiny molecules of the gases. That means the two molecules that present in the gases are collide each other. present in the air. If that gases molecules are collide each other in the presence of the air with the wall of the container. If you see the balloon, the outer surface of the balloon, we call it as a wall. If that gas particles, if the gas particles are collide each other, and if it is collide with the wall of the container, then we can say that the air pressure is exerted. Understood now how exactly the pressure exerted by the gases? In the last class, we discussed about pressure exerted by the liquid, and we saw some of the activities also. And now we discussed about the pressure exerted by the gases. And also in the last class, we discussed about pressure exerted by the solids also. Three concepts we discussed. Pressure exerted by the solids, pressure exerted by the liquids, and the third one is pressure exerted by the gases. Understood the three concepts? Okay, and the next concept we are going to discuss about the atmospheric pressure. What is the next concept we want to discuss? The next concept we want to discuss is atmospheric pressure. Before going to start discussing with the atmospheric pressure, first we want to know about what is this atmosphere. What is this atmosphere? What we call it as an atmosphere? What we call it as an atmosphere? What are the surroundings? Okay, if I stand here means what are the surrounding gases? Okay, if you see surrounding of my, if any of the gases are there or any of the air is present surrounding me, that we call it as an atmosphere. If you tell properly the definition of the atmosphere, what is atmosphere means the layer of the air above the earth. What is atmosphere? The layer of the air above the earth, we call it as an atmosphere. What is atmosphere? The layer of the earth above the surface of the earth, we call it as an atmosphere. Then what is atmospheric pressure? The pressure exerted by the particles of the gases present in the air, then that pressure we call it as an atmospheric pressure. What is atmospheric pressure? The pressure exerted by the gaseous particles. The pressure exerted by the gaseous particles of an air in the atmosphere, we call it as an atmospheric pressure. Understood atmospheric pressure? Atmosphere. After discussing with the atmosphere and the atmospheric pressure, to explain the concept of the atmospheric pressure, the scientist Magdeburg explained some of the experiments to explain the atmospheric pressure. To explain the concept of the atmospheric pressure, the scientist is going to explain one experiment. Now we are going to discuss about the Magdeburg experiment. Okay, what is this Magdeburg experiment? What he going to do? What is this experimental setup he did? Now we are going to discuss. First, he taken two hollow copper hemisphere. First, what he going to take? He going to take two hollow hemisphere. Okay, he not taking the sphere, full sphere. He taken the hollow hemisphere. And he named as an A and B. What we going to do in his experiment? He going to take two hollow hemisphere and he named as A and B. 51 centimeter diameter each. What is the diameter of that hemisphere? The diameter of the hemisphere is 51 centimeter. First, he going to take the two hemisphere in which the diameter of the hemisphere is 51 centimeter. Each hemisphere has a hoop attached to it. One of the hemisphere also has a side tube which can be connected to a vacuum pump. In that two hemisphere, one hemisphere has the vacuum pump. Okay, the one hemisphere want to connect it to the vacuum pump. The two hemisphere are tight, fitting and become the airtight when joined together. We are going to now join this hemisphere. Okay, we are going to join that hemisphere in that one hemisphere as the vacuum and the two hemisphere are joined each other. When air is present inside the joining hemisphere, they can be easily separated by pulling with a small force. If any of the some of the air is present in that hemisphere, means we can easily pull that hemisphere. Okay, if any some of the air is present in that, if some of the air is present in that hemisphere, means we can easily remove that hemisphere. If no air is present, okay, in order to perform next experiment, the two hemisphere are joined together and air is removed completely. First, what he did, he joined the hemisphere in which the air is present. If air is present, means we can easily remove the hemisphere. This is the first step. In the second set, he going to join the hemisphere, but completely he remove the air. Small single one particle of the air is also not present. Okay, he completely remove the hair. What happens if he completely remove the hair, means what happens? There is no pressure. That means there is no particles is there, right? To collide each other. Therefore, what happens then? When all the air is removed from inside the hemisphere, then the two hemisphere cannot be separated even pulling with the large force. If no single air particles is present inside the hemisphere, means we can't remove that hemisphere. Okay, we can't remove that hemisphere. Even we are going to apply the large amount of the force also. Why this happens? Did you think that why it happened? Why we can't remove that hemisphere with applying the large amount of the force also? Why it happens means, this is due to that there is no air inside. Therefore, unopposed atmosphere pressure acting over the whole surface of the hemisphere. If you see, no pressure is there, no air is there, means the outer pressure that exerted in the atmosphere gives the relations with that one, that hemisphere. Okay, and also the pressure on an evacuated hemisphere was a greater that even two teams of the eight arcs each pulling in the opposite direction also, it cannot be separated. Due to the exert of the outer atmosphere and the surface of the hemisphere, we can't remove the hemisphere if you are going to apply the more amount of force also. This is all about the Mengsberg experiment. Okay, this is all about the Mengsberg experiment. And also another one example I am giving to you. Just take one full glass of water. Okay, I am explaining the another one example to explain the atmospheric pressure. Okay, take one full glass of water. For that, you just put one thin cord. Okay, first take one full glass of water and the upper surface, put one thin cord. After some time, you just turn back the glass, okay, by holding like this. If you turn back the glass, the water that present in the glass is not come out. Okay, and that I said that one slide of that paper, that also not thrown to the down. Why? Why the slide will not come to the down or it is removed? Even we are going to make the upward direction. Why means, here also the atmospheric pressure act on that slide of paper. Here also the atmospheric pressure is work on that slide of paper. Understood now exactly what is this atmospheric pressure? After discussing with what is atmospheric pressure and what is the experiment, everything, now we are going to discuss about the applications. Okay, what is this applications? Why we are going to study about the atmospheric pressure? This is the last concept of this lesson. What is the last concept of this lesson? Applications. what are the applications of the atmospheric pressure. Shall we start discussing it one by one? Okay, the first application of the atmospheric pressure is drinking straw. Okay, take an example. When you are going for any of the shop, you are just taking the cold drinks, right? Cold drinks you are going to take, and you are going to ask that, give one straw. After that, you are going to drink that cool drinks by the use of straw. How come that liquid will come to your mouth? You just kept that straw into the cool drinks, and if you are going to apply the some of the pressure to that cool drink, then only the cool drinks will come to in the mouth, right? Right? There also, in the drinking of the cool drinks or drinking of the coconut water, everything by using the straw. This is the best example for the atmospheric pressure. If you are going to give some of the pressure to that, then only the liquid will come to the mouth. Otherwise, it will not come, right? This is the first application of the atmospheric pressure. Second one, syringe. The best example, if you see the syringe, when you go for any of the medical shop or if you are go with the to consult the doctor, if the doctor are going to give the syringe to you, what they first they are going to do? They are going to consider that this is the syringe means, take that this syringe means, they are going to pull back first syringe, right? They are going to pull the syringe backward direction. Why they are going to pull the syringe in the backward direction? They are going to apply the pressure in the backward direction. When they are going to apply the pressure in the backward direction only, the liquid that can enter in the syringe. Then only they are going to give the syringe to your body, right? By applying the pressure in the backward direction, then only they are going to give the syringe. This is also the one of the best application for the atmospheric pressure. One is the drinking straw. Second one is the syringe. Third one is the dropper. If you see, if you are going to take any of the dropper or any of the liquid by using the dropper, means we are going to give some of the pressure, right? We are going to press that dropper. After pressing the dropper, the atmospheric pressure gets some of the force to the dropper. Again, the liquid will go to the dropper, right? Then only we are going to take some of the liquid to the put into the any of the substances. This is also the one of the example. The next one is the rubber sucker. That also same thing. They are going to apply the pressure for that. And if you see that vacuum cleaner, okay, the best example for the rubber sucker is the vacuum cleaner. How that vacuum cleaner is working? What is the principle of that vacuum cleaner? If you see, the principle of the vacuum cleaner is also depend upon the atmospheric pressure only. They are going to apply some of the pressure in that space of that. How it is look like the vacuum cleaner? It is just a rubber sucker. If that complete the pressure, the atmospheric pressure depends upon this. The vacuum cleaner is depends upon the application of the atmospheric pressure only. These are the some of the applications of the atmospheric pressure. What are the some of the applications of the atmospheric pressure? The first is drinking straw, syringe, dropper, and the rubber sucker. These are the applications of the atmospheric pressure. Okay, now I am going to give the overview of the chapter. What we are discussing in this chapter, if you saw, first we are discussed about the force, definition of the force. In the force, we discussed about contact force and non-contact force. Contact force means which have the physical touch, which have the physical relation. That type of the force we call it as a contact force. In the contact forces, in the contact force, we are going to discuss about the two types of the force. One is the muscular force and another one is what? One is the muscular force and another one is the? One is the muscular force and another one we discuss about the frictional force. What are the two types of the contact force we discussed? One is the muscular force and another one is the frictional force. After discussing with the contact forces, next we discussed about the non-contact forces, which doesn't have any physical relation. In that, the first we discuss about the magnetic force. After that, we discuss about the electrostatic force. Then we discuss about the gravitational force. After discussing with the forces, next we start discussing with the pressure. And also we get a formula to find the pressure. Pressure is equals to force by area. We did some of the problems for the finding the pressure. After that, we discussed about how exactly the pressure exerted by the solid, pressure exerted by the liquid, and pressure exerted by the gases. After that, we discuss about the atmospheric pressure, atmosphere, the one experiment to explain the atmosphere, and finally, we discuss about the applications of the atmospheric pressure. In the applications of the atmospheric pressure, we discussed about the drinking straw, syringe, dropper, and the rubber socket. This completes your lesson, force and pressure. Okay, I hope you think understood every concept what I explained. In the next class, we are going to discuss about the new lesson with more of the information. Up to that, bye everyone.